an honor to like have my story told by someone like you.
Well then, but we gotta call it Amy's song.
When Cupid shoots his arrows.
We just arrived at the location. It's 9:30 now, and me and my co-director Sirion, we're gonna start with the choreography.
So when Matt first shared the song with me, and also talked about Amy's story of her struggle of not being able to love a woman, I decided that I first wanted to learn more about the topic, about the LGB community. So I started interviewing a lot of people, and what I quickly learned was that the story of Amy was far more a universal story, and that they all share the same kind of fears and the same kind of doubts. And this really showed me that this was a story I wanted to make together with this community and make sure that we tell the story in the right way. One thing everyone told me was that they all experienced different phases in the process of accepting who you are. And that's when we decided to use those phases as a fundament for the music video.
We are preparing for the rehearsals now. As you can see, all the signs are up.
So the first chapter is about hiding.
Okay, action.
People know who they are, but they are like afraid of showing that to the world. That's why you see all these people behind the sign with the lyrics on it. And at the end, then you see a couple. You can't see their faces. And the couple represents more or less, okay, they have found love, but it's still in secret. So then we slowly move into three people who are standing there all back to back. That's the moment the first person, Bradley, shows himself. Like he's empowered by the people he has found. And then the sign, he's passing through. As if he is inspiring the next one to also be themselves. And that's the moment we slowly turn into the second chapter, where we literally reveal the theme of the whole music video. And then you see two men kissing for the first time. And those are actually my uncles. And they're like the first couple who are really showing their love for each other and also being proud of that. And then we move into all kinds of different couples, actual couples in real life, different ages, and also they are showing their love for each other with pride. So then we slowly transition into this new part where you see this eight different young people standing right behind each other and all making a very powerful statement. A statement of, okay, we have achieved so much by 2018, but why is it still a problem if we love who we love? And this tunnel eventually leads up to this beautiful lady, Nadine. So first you see her all by herself asking this profound question, does your God really give a damn? Then the camera turns around and comes back at Nadine, but then she's joined by her beautiful girlfriend, Marlijn. So they have found true love and they have found each other, and for the first time you see a smile on Nadine's face. So yeah, the camera turns back again for the second time at Nadine and Marlijn. And you see them looking at each other, holding hands, and then walk away, as if they were in public, being totally okay and totally happy with who they are as a couple, and showing and expressing the love for each other in public. That's a very strong and important moment also for themselves. And this walk eventually leads up to some other couples who are also really okay with showing their love for each other in public. And then eventually you see Amy standing there all by herself, looking at all the stories that we have seen. Amy walks towards the group and she turns around and shows the last sign.
Being who I am.
Oh my God, guys.
Oh my God, it's very emotional.
This is the take that, you know, it's amazing.
I just hope it helps a lot of young people.
Everyone was fighting for the same cause and they were all literally running to share this message. We needed four takes to get it all right. And then we decided to look at the last take. And the moment we finished looking at the last take with everyone together, People started hugging each other, started crying, as if all the pain that they all went through and all the shared emotion caused like this really strong connection between all these people who didn't know each other the day before. And to see that happening after a shoot, that was just magical, I think.
Does your God really give a damn? Does your God really give
a damn? It's amazing. It's all about that.